Hello everyone, my name is Elin Zhilov. Today I'm gonna show you how to create the motion tracking in the Blender. And as you know, there are two main ways how to do it, but in this video I just will use the first one, because for me, if I'm not mistaken, it's the most cool way to get more quality good result. Okay, let me show the result. When I start, I have such video. Oh, sorry. And just I try to open. Yeah, this one. I think it's the. Okay, yeah, this one. And then after some actions, I have this. Okay, you can see and. Yeah, it's more easy when your object is too far from you, because it gives you more realistic and just help you get rid of the mistakes. But the most is most difficult when your object too near from you. Okay, just let's start. Go to basics and motion tracking. And firstly, you just have to add the video, just drag or put the video in the Blender. And can you see on the video? You just need to select the most contrast points or pixels. But before we must go to the color management and change the filmic view transform to standard. It'll help you, I think. And the second one, before we start, we need to set the default more good settings for our auto the future work. Okay, let's start. Let's change motion model. Yeah, from location to location, rotation and scale. But of course, you can leave the perspective or fine. Just let's check. Let's set the location, rotation, scale. Just also click to the normalize, and the third, we need to go to the tracking setting extra and to change the correlation from this one to 0.9. Okay, it's okay. And okay, before also we start, just let's click to preferred. It's just give us the full way. How to explain? Okay, my English is not so good. Okay, just it's caching our video. Okay, it's done. It maybe take you 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, let's start. As I've already said, we have two ways, and in this video I use the first one. Okay, just we need to choose the most contrast points. I think we can choose this one and just hold the control and click on the left button, and just you can to increase, just enlarges your this area of the search, your point, and also go to tracking. And yeah, but I don't recommend the start from the beginning of the video, and I recommend you go to the middle. Okay, and just click here. I think it's give you a more good result. And just yeah, in contrast point, and you can use the step-by-step tracking, something like that. It's works good. Also, you can just fully tracking for your video. Okay. Just sometimes you of course need to correct the search area, because it depends on the normalize. It's something sometimes just destroyed. It's okay, don't worry about that, and just correct. Okay, yeah, it's automatically, yeah, for example like this, and just go to the previous frame and just correct something like this. Okay, your search area just influence on your CPU, the power of your computer. And just if you don't have a good computer, just you can to decrease the scale, and let's continue. It's okay. One more time. Okay, it's good. It's quite good. And now we can see the end of our frames in the tracking. It's okay. Don't worry about it. And let's check another one. For example, this one. And of course, we have the similar points, and it can destroy our tracking in the future. And just let's increase the area, something like this, and click C. It's like a scale, and let's decrease on the y-axis, for example, like this. And let's continue. Okay, it's good. And another one, another side correctly. Okay, just how to say, I just fastened the video and then just continue. Okay, I just forgot to say, in this and such work, I don't recommend you to set the control points on the moving object, something like this, because it's give you not quality good result and more large error factors. And okay, I also just forgot to say about the you can I've said about it, but I didn't show it. Okay, just click on this point, and you can use step-by-step mode tracking and something like that. Oh no, I'm mistaken. And to another side, and this point, yeah, something. Okay, just let's go to to recent frame. Okay, something like that, and click on this point, something like this. And yeah, but it's more suitable when you work with near points, for example this, maybe this one. Yeah, but let's just finish it. Okay. Okay, now we need to find out the errors and go to solve. Okay, we just go to solve and click on the keyframes, because it just will calculate on only all your frames, like a video. No, okay, I think you understand. Okay, it will be calculated as far as longer as your video is. Okay, and just go to fine and click the focal length K1 and K2. I don't know why, just it's default, I think. And yeah, it's okay. And you just leave to click on the solve camera motion, and it'll give your mistake errors. Okay. Fail to solve the motion, most likely there are not good keyframes. Okay, I think it's mean that you need to add more details, more point markers. And let's click here and just let's calculate, return, and to another side. Okay, it's okay. Let's repeat. Okay. Oh, solve errors 0.10 pixels. I think it's absolutely good result, because all the result that less than one, it's really good. Okay, it's okay. And the first part, just what we did, okay, just we created the motion tracking point controls and get a quite good result, because this solve error is really cool. Oh, Okay, and in the next part, I show you how to put your 3D models in your scenes and how to set the scenes for your future operations. Okay, and thank you for the watching, and if you like this video, click the likes, and I really appreciate it. Bye. Oh, okay, I just forgot to say, if your errors is not good, and just go to clean up and clean tracks, click on this. Okay, just for example show you, and clean tracks and go to the clean. And what you need to do if your mistake more just highest than one, and just set here double values. For example, if you would be got the 1.5, you must to click here just 3, and this one check all these trackings who show the double results, and just delete, and then you repeat your actions, just soft camera motion, and this volume must be increase. Oh, decrease, of course, decrease. And if it's not enough for you, and you think there's a very big errors, solve, you can just repeat your actions. I think it will be enough. Okay, thank you. Bye.